Google Colab provides you an interactive platform that let you run your Python code on your browser, and so you don't need to install Python, right? Using Google Colab, you can use any latex syntax. You can write any math equation in latex format, and you can use HTML code here. So let's see how you can do it. First of all, you have to open your browser. Now you can see that I have already opened my browser, and here this is all about the Google Colab and what are the various functionalities it provides. So to implement it one by one, let's start with these. Here you can see we have a option file. Go to file and create a new notebook. Okay, so when you create a new notebook, a new tab will be open and it will be a blank sheet. So it will take a few seconds to open that blank notebook to you. So first of all, what you can do is you can first change your title, right? So your title is my first Colab notebook. Okay. Then here you can see this is a space, okay, which is a list actually. So Google Colab provides you two type of lists, which is code and text. So these are the two spaces or two list spaces that it provides. If you want to code it, by default it's your cursor is blinking on this code, okay, and by writing this code you can execute it from here. Let's write first code. Print hello, right? So to execute you have to click on this, or you can use Control plus Enter for a shortcut key, right? And it's executed. Okay, now it's done and you can see the output is hello, right? It's so simple. And for this other cell, which is a text cell, you can add it. You can edit from here, you can edit, you can add from here, right? So let's add me from here, right? So now you can see that here we have this space and you can use writing your text. So this is my first notebook, right? Now you will see the output of this script is here. And now if you want to use a font, another font style, I want to increase this font size, then you have to click TT, right? If you want it into bold, you can use B, and for italics you can use I. So it's like that. The changes will try. So here we have other options, like you can link this, so you can insert a link, right, directly from your browser. You can format it like a code, okay? Now, and also you can insert an image from your devices, right, from your desktop, or where have you stored an image. You can change your ident level, and you can also store some list items like in this using this style of numbered style, or in this bullet style. So let me write some items here that I want to cover those topics. Okay, let me write that. So first of all, I will write some code, right? So I have written some code. So see how we can simply call a call a module in import a module in this Google notebook. So importing module, right? Importing module, and then we will see that how we can insert a math equation using latex, okay, in Google Colab notebook. So I'm just creating this index or list item just to, okay, now we have another list item, so you can create it as well using this. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, I have changed my number, so you are seeing those on spaces, then you can use like that. And then how we can insert an HTML code, okay, HTML script or code here. So HTML code, right? Or you can say HTML tags actually. Now at last we will see some installations or installation of libraries and installation libraries, right? So the agenda of this is this lecture or this video session is to use these concepts in Google Colab. So how can you use this? So first of all, importing module. You can import your module just by clicking on adding a code cell. So you can add a code cell in two ways. You can from here, and you can use directly from here, right? It provides you two options here at the end of a cell. So to insert a code cell, just click on the code cell. So importing module. So how we can import a module? We have so many modules in Python. So let's import a module called numpy. Okay, numpy is a module which is stand for numerical Python. So you can use this module like import, right? Import numpy, right? NumPy, as you write it will give you a it will show you some suggestions that you can use, so it's so easy. So now I'm clicking on import numpy. So as np it will like create an object of this library, so you can access anything. NumPy as np, so it's used for numerical calculations. So in the upcoming videos we will see that how we can use the NPY, right? So we have another modules like import pandas library. Pandas is for when you create data frame and you can analyze some data using some data analytics tool. So here the pandas plays a crucial role and it's make things easy for you, right? Import pandas as pd, and now you can, okay, so this is how we can import some modules. And now let's see how we can we insert an equations using latex, right? So for that, what you have to do, you have to insert a text cell, okay? In a text cell you can use, if you know the latex syntax. If you don't know the latex syntax, I will tell you that first it starts from the dollar, okay? It starts from the dollar, and then you write something in like that x, okay? Now using the some parentheses. Now a caret symbol, because I want to write x square, so now you can use this, okay? So now it's end with dollar, right? So you will see here we have this x square, right? So let me do something like x square minus 1. So you can see the changes here. So in that way you can insert a equation in using this using the Google notebook. So it's very easy, and you will see it's clean and clear, looks good. Okay, now the third is insert HTML code. So HTML code is just using your text cell, you can insert an HTML code. So let me write something like HTML code, right? HTML code. So I want to create just a title of this cell, because okay, so it will be readable to you. So let me do this here, just math equation, right? Math equation. So now we have this bold letter. So now it looks good, and one can easily see that how we can use these text and code cell. So for the first time, it's a good practice if you use the text cell for each your coding cell, so that you can easily remember what these cells are, what these codes are for what, and you can, when you share with your friends your coding script, so they must understand that what you have written. So it's for, you can say that it's for enhancing readability. So let's come back to this HTML code, right? So for that, use the HTML, you have to use 2% symbol, right? And then you have to write HTML, so it will invoke HTML. Okay. And so let's use marquee command, okay? So marquee, and then let me just hello. All right, so now hello, okay, and then close this marquee tag. So for that we have this marquee, right? Now when you execute it, you will see that here the hello is coming from the right side, right? So it's like that. So you can use your Python notebooks for the number of things, okay, without taking much headache about the installations of Python or executing environment and all this. So the last is installations library. So you can install any library using the pip command, right? So using pip command, right? So let me create a heading for that. Okay, installation libraries, right? Libraries. So again, you can use some increase font size or so. Now you can use this using pip install and any library you want, okay? Any library. So you can use pip install. Right now I'm using Jensim library, so it start executing, and Jensim is a library which has some modules like